All right, we're back, guys, for round two. Hope you guys are ready. We're 1-0 in the daily. Woo, 1-0, woo. All righty. Looks like we're on the draw. And a very keepable hand here. Lead with a forest. Draw a shrine. Okay. Got some good stuff going on here. Decent stuff. Warden of the first tree. Alright. Yeah, I could hide with deck I'm playing, but I don't think it's that serious. Like, I'm playing the Rattleclaw, so it's more than obvious what deck I'm playing. I could have played forest. Kind of bluffed, but nah. Okay. Interesting. I could either sky spawn here. Sky spawn, Rattleclaw. I got like sky spawn. I don't really like casting Nessa. We already have more than enough forest in play. I like this line because even if my Rattleclaw dies, I can still cast Whisperwood. Seems pretty good. Yep, there's a Tower Protector getting back land, which is fine. I feel pretty safe with this line. Like, I'm forcing my opponent to either pump or just kill one of my creatures. So if they pump, I'm fine with a straight. Like, next turn I slam Whisperwood. So if we don't draw land next turn, we can play Nessa into face down Rattleclaw. Set up a dig through time turn. If they're going to catch the Siege Rhino, they can't attack with Den Protector. If they attack with Den Protector, I still block because Abzan Charm. Oh, Hanger Back. I could care less about that card. I'm going to play Nessa here. Hmm. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's see. Play 2 to flip this face up. That's 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'll have 8 mana, so I can cast it Ugin if I draw it. And go ahead and attack with the face down. Wants to trade it for HVAC, that's fine. Wants to trade it for Dim Protector, that's also fine. Sure. They can possibly be going for Wingmate Rock, but I'm not really terrified of Wingmate Rock either. I just need to draw a Lugin. They manifested a land. Shrine, unfortunately. I'm fine with that trade. That means my dig through time is even cheaper. I'm not under any pressure now, and they can't cast Wingmate Rock. So next turn I can like Sky Spawner into dig through time. I have another Den Protector. Oh, I guess I can't dig through time. I don't have blue anymore. Let's see if my opponent wants a Dim Protector chain or do something else. Anaphensis, fine. Sure. Yeah, he's going to Dim Protector chain here. That's also fine. Okay. I was gonna say, I think racing favors me if my opponent is attacking with the Thopters. I can just swing my whole team. Next, I think I'll just hang back. I got dig through time next turn. Alright, so let's see, what do we want to do here? I can dig through time for 4. Let's see, tap, tap. It's kind of awkward. I guess I take Shrine and a Whisperwood here. I think I'm short of Ulamog. 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, I'm literally 1 mana short. One mana short. Can I just pass here? Oh, I'm dead. He can fight Anathenza here and then do that. I guess he can also do it this way too. Because I'm exactly 8. I can't block the Den Protector, basically. Oh boy. I need one more turn. He can actually attack with everything, but he doesn't need to. Just needs to attack with these three creatures. Put a counter on either one, because I can't block. As long as he's attacking at me, he is. Let's see where his counter goes. Yeah. All right. What do we want here? Maybe a couple of wins, a couple of disdainful strokes, a couple of dispels, maybe. Excuse me. Got a sky spawner here. I guess I'm on the play though. So being on the play is a little bit weird. Because I kind of want to be as aggressive as possible. I don't know if I would want to worry about what my opponent's doing. I probably just want to do my own thing. Maybe I don't sideboard at all. I'm going to think about it a little bit here. Contemplates with my mind. I guess I can cut the Nessus for some wins, maybe. Let's try to go big. I'll keep this hand. It's perfect for the go big plan, I guess. Like, Rattle Claw Mystic into Drowner into Ugin's in this pretty big game. Second Ugin is definitely something we don't want to see there. That's a little bit unfortunate. I guess they're gonna take my Drowner, because I mean, I have two Ugins. Drowner is clearly more easy castable than Ugin. Hopefully, we draw like a mana ramp spell here. No, just another Ugin. For value, of course. Now, three Ugins is too many, obviously. Yep. So, well, my opponent's like, oh, he drew another Ugin. That was a good draw. Sky Spotter, play land here. Like a Den Protector. Drowner? So like, they can Den Protector transgress, but next turn I can cast... If I draw a land, I can cast Ugin anyway. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Looks like they're not even going for that line anymore. They're just keeping me off mana. One, two, three, four. One turn? We definitely beat down here. Like, another way I win this game is I just, you know, kill them. One, two, three, four, five. Yeah, one mana short. I can just kill my opponent. Like, they're at 8 life right now. They'd just be dead. Like, they have to start worrying about my actual clock. My opponent's just dead here if they transgress. I just tap down their team. I don't know if they know what Drowner does. Like, I just tap down both of these creatures and kill them. Power of Drowner of Hope. Drowns your opponent's hopes. You're at 7. I have 7 power. Alright. Game 3, I kind of like the deck how it is. We're going to be on the draw, so it's like possible we want. Maybe some Disdainful Strokes over these wins. Yeah. I think I just want to leave the shell as is. Just bring the Disdainful Strokes on the play. Yeah, this is fine. Stance slow, but I'm going to keep it. Stance real slow. And sped up quite a bit. Might be a transgress. Fine, I mean, they are not applying pressure yet. I think they still have to take... Oh, they take Sky Spawner? Really? Okay. Could be an Anafenza, which is, you know, actual pressure, or it could be a space down gen pressure, which is like, okay, I don't care. Anafenza. Okay, so it's actual pressure for once. Put one of those into play, put this into play. We're at 6 mana next turn, which is enough for Drowner of Hope. They could have the CGiest of rhinos here, though. CGiest. Rest. Alright. Well, there goes Ugin. Pass it up. Bank transgress here. See if he actually runs it out. Yes. Well, I ain't got nothing, so. she attacks, I'm blocking the Den Protector. Step down and offensive, swing with Drowner and Leaf Scepter. Play another Drowner. Once again, Drowner of Hopes is crushing in here. Next turn, we can even attack with a Lumbering Ball. Seems pretty good. Look, like we're in a pretty good position here. So here I would actually tap down an offensive before attacks. Okay. Guessing our opponent has Dromoka's Command. It's probably correct just to get Gideon off the table here. Thinking here. So I can, if I activate this, and I have 4 mana, but I kind of want to save the Scion. Borden. Everything. So I just lose a Lumbering Falls here. My opponent takes 5 down to 6. These rhinos get draw. Last card in my opponent's hand is Den Protector. I think they're debating on playing it face up or whatever. I'm definitely attacking with both drowners. The question is, do I attack with anything else? I don't think so. Really? My opponent's objects are pretty good. Opponent's draws are really good. Our draws are pretty good. Interesting they attacked. Definitely fine with this trade. Buys me more time. They can't, like, then protector chain some more, basically. Now we have an actual clock. Checking for two. Sanctum pass. Could be we mate rock. It's another siege right now. That was a good draw. That was a cool manifest. There's an Ugin. I didn't think that was a bad idea for my opponent. my opponent's at 10. I guess I'm 1 damage short. I guess I needed my manifest to be like an actual creature there. Sure. Well, they needed to attack with Shambling Vin so that my flyer wasn't lethal. But since they didn't, I just attacked with my flyer. They had to attack with that last turn. Alright, and we win the match. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll be back again for round 3.